A Week on the Concord and Merrimack Rivers by Henry David Thoreau. Where'er thou sailest who sailed with me, though now thou climb'st loftier mounts, and fairer rivers dost ascend, be thou my muse, my brother. I am bound for a distant shore, by a lonely isle, by a far Azore. There it is, the treasure I seek, on the barren sands of a desolate creek. I sailed up a river with a pleasant wind, new lands, new people, and new thoughts to find. Many fair reaches and headlands appeared, and many dangers were there to be feared. But when I remember where I have been, and the fair landscapes that I have seen, thou seem'st the only permanent shore, the cape never rounded, nor wandered o'er. Concord River. Beneath low hills, in the broad interval, through which at will our Indian rivulet winds mindful still of senep and of squaw, whose pipe and arrow oft the plough unburies, here in pine houses built of new-fallen trees, supplanters of the tribe, the farmers dwell. Emerson. The Musketaquid, or grass-ground river, though probably as old as the Nile or Euphrates, did not begin to have a place in civilized history until the fame of its grassy meadows and its fish attracted settlers out of England in 1635, when it received the other but kindred name of Concord from the first plantation on its banks, which appears to have been commenced in a spirit of peace and harmony. It will be grass-ground river as long as grass grows and water runs here. It will be Concord River only while men lead peaceable lives on its banks. To an extinct race, it was grass-ground, where they hunted and fished. And it is still perennial grass-ground to Concord farmers, who own the great meadows, and get the hay from year to year. One branch of it, according to the historian of Concord, for I love to quote so good authority, rises in the south part of Hopkinton, and another from a pond and a large cedar swamp in Westborough. And flowing between Hopkinton and Southborough, through Framingham, and between Sudbury and Wayland, where it is sometimes called Sudbury River, it enters Concord at the south part of the town. And after receiving the North or Assabeth River, which has its source a little further to the north and west, goes out at the northeast angle, and flowing between Bedford and Carlisle, and through Billerica, and empties into the Merrimack at Lowell. In Concord it is, in summer, from 4 to 15 feet deep, and from 100 to 300 feet wide. But in the spring freshets, when it overflows its banks, it is in some places nearly a mile wide. Between Sudbury and Wayland the meadows acquire their greatest breadth, and when covered with water they form a handsome chain of shallow vernal lakes, resorted to by numerous gulls and ducks. Just above Sherman's Bridge, between these towns, is the largest expanse, and when the wind blows freshly in a raw March day, heaving up the surface into dark and sober billows or regular swells, skirted as it is in the distance with alder swamps and smoke-like maples, it looks like a smaller Lake Huron, and it is very pleasant and exciting for a landsman to row or sail over. The farmhouses along the Sudbury shore, which rises gently to a considerable height, command fine water prospects at this season. The shore is more flat on the Wayland side, and this town is the greatest loser by the flood. Its farmers tell me that thousands of acres are flooded now, since the dams have been erected, where they remember to have seen the white honeysuckle or clover growing ones.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.